So in this video, I'm gonna walk you step by step on how to set up a Twitch chat overlay inside of Streamlabs so you can show your chat on stream. So the first thing you're gonna do is open up Streamlabs desktop. If you don't have Streamlabs desktop installed, I'll put a link in the description of this video. So once you're here, we're gonna go ahead and select the scene where you're gonna want to add your chat. So you have your starting soon, you have your countdown timer, your be right back, your stream offline. And then typically where you add your chat is typically in your gameplay scene or in your just chatting scene. So to be able to go ahead and add this, we're gonna go ahead and select our just chatting scene, and we're gonna have a open box just like this. Now, if you're interested in the overlays that I'm utilizing here today, I went ahead and got them from streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. They have tons of animated overlays you can go ahead and choose from based on your liking. And for this example, I'm using the Pixel World package. That's gonna go ahead and bring in all of the overlays that we need, like our screens and our just chatting here to be able to add our chat. So once you have your overlays, we'll come here to Streamlabs and we'll go ahead and go to the scene where we wanna add our chat. So I'm gonna say just chatting. I'm gonna select this little plus icon. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scroll down to where it says here, chat box. I'm gonna select add source. We're gonna name this chat box, add source again. And now this is where we're gonna begin to customize our chat box. Now, the first thing is that I like to go ahead and utilize the theme box because it's gonna make it look cleaner when you have the name, when you have the chat message and the actual icons. Then you can go ahead and decide whether you always want to show the message or you want them to disappear. I like to go ahead and use show message because you'll see here that there's an ending point and they'll naturally just disappear once they're gone. So hide delayed, I leave it as is at 15 seconds. And then here where it says badges for you, you'll have them all checked. But me personally, I just like to have show moderator badge, show subscriber badge, and show Twitch Prime badge. You can select which ones you want to be able to utilize. Then for the extra emotes, I always select all three. And then here for the text color, you can decide what color you want the text to appear. I'm gonna go ahead and select white. And then for the font size, this is also personal preference, but I found 18 to be a good size to be able to be seen. Then the background color, this is gonna be for the box. I like to leave it at black because I have white text. And then here, hide characters. This is a personal preference. If you do not want your chatbot to pop up inside of this box, you can go ahead and check this, and that's gonna hide your chatbot like Nightbot or any bot that you have. Or if you wanna hide commands, so when people put exclamation mark, you know, scene or anything of that sort, you can also go ahead and hide that. I typically just leave them there. And then I go ahead and come down to browser settings. This is gonna be the most important part here because what you're gonna wanna see is if I just hit close, it's gonna go ahead and give me a box that's way bigger than my just chatting area. So what I wanna do first is customize it so it fits directly in here. If you just go ahead and size it, if you just go ahead and size it or crop it in any kind of way, then what's gonna happen is that your text for your chat is gonna get cut off. So you wanna go ahead and make sure you size it here under the browser settings. So we'll come back down here to browser settings. And you'll have to go ahead and mess around with this based on the overlay that you got, based on the chat box space. So for this one here, it's gonna be 325 for the actual width. And then for the height, it's gonna be 550. Then I'm gonna go ahead and select close. And you're gonna see here that now my box is gonna go ahead and fit in here right now. So I'm gonna come back here. I'm gonna change this up, go to browser setting. And for here, I'm just gonna make it a little bit smaller. So you can see that's a little bit still a little bit taller. So I'm just gonna go 500. I'm gonna probably bring this down a little bit more to maybe 300. And then I'm gonna go ahead and size this up. So you can see here that now I have my chat box and it's still gonna be a little bit wider and a little bit taller than what I want. The height of it is totally fine. What you wanna worry about is the actual size. So I'm just gonna go with option. I'm just gonna bring this down to at the top and now I have that size there. So now in order for us to be able to test this, you want to go ahead and go to your Twitch account, go to your actual chat, and you just want to type in here, this is a test a few times to be able to see what it looks like. And then I encourage you to put in a longer message to see what longer messages look like. So this is a test to see how longer messages appear inside of Streamlabs. So hit enter, and now we can come back to Streamlabs and we'll be able to see here that now our messages are popping up and this is what box looks like. So this is a test, this is a test, this is a test to see how long a message looks. And now you can go ahead and lock this. And the beautiful thing is that you can come back here to your gameplay scene, hit this little plus icon, you'll come down and select chat box, add source. And because you've already created it, you can go ahead and select it there, add source. And now my chatbot is right here and I can place it here on my gameplay scene as well. And if we come back here to our Twitch account and do the same thing, this is a test. This is a test. You're gonna see here that now in my gameplay scene, that is also going to go ahead and pop up. And on my just chatting, this is gonna go ahead and pop up here. Now, one of the things that you want to be able to do, if you wanna add a little bit more excitement to your stream when you're switching between different scenes and want to have a stinger transition or an animation that happens between the scenes, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on how to set up a stinger transition inside of Streamlabs. I'll see you guys in the next video.